Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here with a Let's Make It Easier Photoshop tutorial. One of my viewers sent me a link to an interweaving Photoshop effect, which they were having some difficulty completing. Taking a look at the tutorial, it's very tedious. In step 8 and 12, each horizontal and vertical row and column need to be individually selected with the marquee tool. So I thought to myself, there has to be an easier and shorter way to achieve this effect, right? And that's when I remembered that Photoshop CS6 has a new scripted patterns feature. Let me show you how this effect can be achieved in a much shorter amount of time. Before we even touch our image, we need to create the pattern that Photoshop will use to create this effect. For the patterns document, the size is going to be set to 50 by 25 pixels. We only need to create one of the weaves. If you want larger or smaller weaves, you can always go back and create a larger or smaller document with the exact same settings that I'm about to show you. When the document's been created, we're going to head straight into our layer styles to add a gradient and a slight highlight at the top. For the gradient overlay, start by setting the angle at 0 degrees and set the style to reflected. Now, hop into the gradient editor to define your colors. The color on the right will act as the shadow that appears underneath as the design is interweaving. It's going to be a dark gray. Now, the color on the left is going to be a much lighter gray, but not pure white. These two colors are going to work really well when you go to blend your pattern with the image in the background. Now, when you accept the gradient, you may want to increase the scale just a little bit to pull the shadow away from the center. Finally, let's add an inner shadow, which is going to act as a highlight to give our pattern a little bit of depth. The blend mode is going to be changed to overlay, the color is going to be set to white, and the opacity around 40%. Down below, go ahead and set the angle at 90 degrees, the distance at 2 pixels, and the size at 0. Perfect. That's going to do it for the layer styles, and our pattern is complete. Very, very simple. Now, to save this pattern, you can use the Define Pattern option under the Edit menu. This will allow you to save that pattern, which you'll be able to access in Photoshop's pattern pickers. So now that our pattern has been saved, let's hop back over to our image. This image is from Shutterstock.com, but of course you can use any of your own images if you wish. To keep this design non-destructive, we're going to be applying this pattern onto a new layer. You can quickly create a new layer by pressing the New Layer icon at the bottom of your Layers panel, or with the Command-Option-Shift-N shortcut on the Mac, Control-Alt-Shift-N shortcut on Windows. Once the layer has been created, we can now use the Scripted Patterns feature. This can be found in Photoshop's Fill window, which is located under the Edit menu. When the window is visible, start by choosing Pattern for the contents, and then open up the Pattern Picker right below. If you saved your pattern correctly, it should be at the very bottom of the picker. Once it's been chosen, at the bottom of the fill window, you're going to find the scripted patterns option. Again, this is only available in Photoshop CS6. Here, you'll want to choose the crossweave preset, and when you press OK, Photoshop will generate an interweaving effect using the pattern that we created a few moments ago. You may notice a little bit of color has been introduced on the pattern. It won't appear much once we blend it, but if you want to quickly get rid of it, Command or Control, Shift, and U will desaturate that layer. Now, to blend the pattern with the image, you can use a variety of blending modes, which will give you different results. Personally, the Multiply Blend mode gave me a pretty decent result for this image. A bit dark, but we'll deal with that in a moment. Your images may require some experimentation with the other modes, such as Overlay or Soft Light. Now, to brighten up the pattern to touch, I'm going to be adding a levels adjustment layer, and I want to make sure to clip it so that it only affects my pattern and not the image behind it. Now we can go ahead and increase the midtones and highlights to brighten up the pattern. Finally, the last step that you may want to take is to fill in the holes behind the pattern. You can either apply a drop shadow to the pattern's layer if you want the background image to remain visible, or you can apply a black stroke to completely fill in the holes. Either way, you're going to be left with a pretty neat looking interweaving effect created with a simple pattern and Photoshop CS6's new scripted patterns feature. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, please like this video, share it with your friends, and check out my other tutorials at ICEFLOWSTUDIOS.com. Take care.